I'm curious to get your reflection on the kind of the theme of the a book impromptu. That when I was kind of last year when we were all playing with GPT-4, I said, okay, how do I try to show, not just tell, the theory of human amplification? It's like, well, why don't I do a book with GPT-4 as a way of showing, like, directly, here is an amplification moment. How much do you think I'm right on the human amplification, like the amplification intelligence, and how much do you think I'm just kind of being a little too quick on it? What's your reflex on the tool amplifying humanity?
Strongly agree. Like that's where we would like to push things as much as we can to go. You don't get to push technology that much, but you get to do it a little bit around the edges. And thankfully, in this case, it seems like that's where the technology organically wants to go. And I saw a tweet that stuck with me, just someone who said they never thought they would get to coexist with an intelligence as powerful as GPT-4. By the time you got here, you were like deep into the AGI land. And it turns out that it has been more possible than many people thought to build a version of AI that is really good at amplifying individual human will and making us all more productive and better at what we do. And more than that, it turns out that people really love it. One of the most gratifying parts for me of OpenAI is how much people love the product and get all kinds of incredible benefits from it.
Greg, anything to add before we move on to a few other subjects?
I really agree with what Sam said, and I think it's worth really considering, like, why do we build technology in the first place? And fundamentally, it's to improve humanity, to improve human lives, to be able to achieve more. And I think that we're really seeing that unfolding right now, even in the current phase. And I think that even as you move to more capable systems, it's going to be extremely important to make sure that we're really architecting them for that purpose, right? That you have an answer for the human as the manager, the human as the end recipient, humanity as the beneficiary of this technology. Like all of those things, that's part of our mission, is to really make sure that we have an answer for, like, how humanity continues to fit in and continues to be the end beneficiary of all of these systems, kind of almost no matter how smart they get.